And now for a different kind of media story and a question. Does it matter who owns the TV station that delivers your local news? Polls show that many Americans trust local news more than other sources. The largest owner of local stations in the country, Sinclair Broadcasting, is planning a merger that would make them even bigger. It is a move that is raising concerns because of Sinclair's policy of combining news with partisan political opinion. William Brangham has the story.
A train derailment in Tennessee.
Some routine road maintenance has led to a squabble.
We have some breaking news to tell you about. This is out of Bethesda tonight.
Night after night, the country's largest owner of local TV stations, the Sinclair Broadcast Group, reaches over a third of homes across the nation.
Compromise plan for the controversial Canisius Inn.
Most of us think of local news as just that, local. Stations run local stories produced and reported by local people. But if recently you tuned into, say, WVTV, which is Sinclair's station in Milwaukee, you saw this.
Does the president have to repeat that fact day in and day out for us to believe it?
That's Boris Epstein, former member of the Trump administration and now chief political analyst for Sinclair. And here he was again on WEAR in Pensacola.
The president stating the fact that the fringes of the left and the right.
And on KSAS in Wichita.
Are both capable of hate and violence does not mean he's condoning any of it.
And again and again on every single one of the 173 Sinclair stations across the country. On those stations, you might also see these.
We should only tear down the bad statues, one viewer told me. But who decides what is bad?
That's Sinclair executive Mark Hyman.
What responsible adult hasn't pointed to a scar as a reminder to not repeat a foolish act from their youth?
Or these, the weekly so-called terrorism alert desk.
From the terrorism alert desk in Washington, I'm Allison Starling.
Sinclair mandates that these clearly conservative editorials and features get broadcast on every one of their local stations. In some cases, stations have to run them as often as 9 times a week. Eric Lipton is a reporter for the New York Times who's been covering Sinclair.
They have, you know, what they call must runs, which include Boris Epstein, who was a surrogate for Trump, who is, you know, on the air talking about conservative issues. You know, while the local news stations largely decide what their local news is going to be, you know, a covering of local government crime and local issues, there are these must runs that go on their networks across the United States, which are, have a decidedly conservative flavor.
This partisan tilt has many free speech advocates alarmed because not only does Sinclair own such a large chunk of the marketplace already, but it's hoping to get bigger still. If a proposed $4 billion merger with Tribune Media goes forward, Sinclair would now reach 3 out of 4 American households. Journalism professor and former Milwaukee station manager Louis Friedland.
It is a real step in a very different direction to begin to say that the most trusted news source of most Americans is going to be allowed to be turned into an opinion organization, opinion machine, for a very narrow, narrowly conservative point of view night after night in local communities.
Television remains the main source of news for many Americans. In 2016, 46% of adults said they got their news from local TV stations. And it's information they trust. 41% of registered voters said they trust local news to tell the truth, while just 27% trust national news. Sinclair disputes having any kind of a political bent. Its executives declined to talk with us on camera for this report. But the record shows that the Maryland-based company has used its ownership of stations to push partisan conservative viewpoints for years. For example, after the 9/11 attacks, Sinclair required anchors and reporters to read messages supporting President George Bush's efforts against terrorism.
The names and the faces of the fallen tell their own story.
In 2004, when ABC News Nightline devoted an entire show to reading the names of U.S. service members who had died in Iraq,
Kendall Waters Bay. Sorrell Childers.
Sinclair, which owned 7 ABC affiliates at the time, barred those stations from showing the broadcast. Later that year, in the midst of the presidential campaign between John Kerry and President George Bush, Sinclair mandated all its stations run a special that included clips from a distinctly one-sided documentary that questioned John Kerry's Vietnam War service.
I was outraged, and still am, that he willingly said things which were untrue.
And more recently, Sinclair had its stations run this segment, which called the national media purveyors of fake news.
Unfortunately, some members of the national media are using their platforms to push their own personal bias and agenda to control exactly what people think.
If the opinions were confined just to the commentary...
Sinclair even caught the eye of HBO's John Oliver, who poked fun at how Sinclair sometimes forces conservative talking points into the scripts that their local news anchors read.
Did the FBI have a personal vendetta in pursuing the Russia investigation of President Trump's former national security advisor, Michael Flynn?
Did the FBI have a personal vendetta
in pursuing the Russia investigation of
President Trump's former national security advisor, Michael Flynn?
This blurring of news and opinion is one criticism of the company. The blurring of news and advertising is another.
Hey, $2 fish sandwich.
There are numerous examples of Sinclair stations running what are largely paid promotions masquerading as news pieces.
More and more patients at Huntsman Cancer Institute are recording their life stories.
Like in this case, where Sinclair stations across the country ran these segments about the Huntsman Cancer Institute. They looked like news spots, but were in fact funded by the Cancer Center, something viewers were not told. The FCC is still investigating that case. Sinclair's bid to buy Tribune Media and thus expand its reach dramatically in the local news market has drawn plenty of criticism. Sinclair says critics have it wrong. They say it's about economics. Quote, the proposed merger will advance the public interest by helping to shore up an industry buffeted by well-known economic challenges.
Traditionally, to protect against any one company becoming too dominant, Congress has set certain caps on how many media outlets one corporation can own in a given market. But the FCC recently changed those rules.
Under the new leadership of Trump appointee Ajit Pai, the FCC has now made it easier to approve Sinclair's expansion.
All of those in favor say
Tom Wheeler is the former chair of the FCC. He thinks these new changes are a blow to a free and vibrant press.
The Trump FCC has, in one very short period, moved to change three basic rules that have been in place to protect the diversity of voices and avoid monopolization of the broadcast television market. We have a society in which the flow of information is crucial to a democracy. And when that free flow of information gets choked off by corporate consolidation, we ought to all worry.
Eric Lipton of the New York Times discovered meetings and correspondence between Ajit Pai and Sinclair executives that he says raises questions about the company's influence with the Trump administration.
He met with the executive officers of Sinclair just a few days before Trump was inaugurated, where they made clear to him that they were looking for the Trump administration to roll back some of these restrictions that were essentially limiting their ability to get bigger. And it was just a matter of a couple weeks when all of a sudden Pai was named chairman and he was actually rolling back the same rules that they had approached him on. And only as a result of rolling back these rules is Sinclair merger going to be able to go through.
It's not just as Chairman Pai is suggesting a simple shift in ownership regulations. It's actually a shift in our entire broadcast ecosystem.
A final FCC decision on the Sinclair Tribune deal is expected later this year. In Washington, D.C., I'm William Brangham for the PBS NewsHour.